This is Robert Kraft, and I'm coming to you live on SNNLive, and we're at the Bio CEO and Investor Conference 2019 in New York. With me right now is Venkat Nelabhotla from Vyome Therapeutics, Inc. It's a private company. Venkat, welcome to SNNLive.
Thank you very much.
It's great to have you on. So for our audience, let's start off with an overview of the company, and then we'll go from there.
Yeah, so we are actually focused on very unique unmet needs in dermatology indications, which is the antibiotic resistance in skin infections. And our lead asset is more focused on the acne, antibiotic resistant acne.
So let's get a history of the company. When did it start and how did you develop to where you're currently at today?
We've started this company with our labs in India, where we've done all the early discovery work with a deep genomic understanding of the microbes that are involved in causing skin infections, including acne and other skin skin bacterial infections and fungal infections. And we've got a couple of platform technologies with 5 to 6 products. And our lead asset is for moderate to severe acne, where there's a big unmet need of antibiotic-resistant acne. And in US, we have more than 10 million patients, you know, which is like the size of New York City. And this problem is very embarrassing and a big problem for teenagers and, 20 plus adults.
You know, look, I was one of those teenagers, you know, I had issues with acne and there was always all these different types of treatments out there. There's over the counter, you know, there were some things that were available that, you know, doctors would recommend. But how is what you're developing different than what doctors were previously recommending teenagers and those suffering with moderate to difficult acne?
Yeah. So precisely. So we have a serious problem out there. There is not much of an innovation at a very fundamental level, understanding the P. acne microbial genetics and how it interacts with the skin. And you've been having very old antibiotics there, clindamycin and minocycline. So there has been a significant resistance that got developed because of which cure rates are less than 45%. So we've picked up a new class, first in class of an antibiotic that works on the antibiotic-resistant P. acne, and as well as it works on the multifactorial pathogenesis. It clears inflammation, and we believe that it's going to fulfill a big unmet need. And we estimate at proper pricing, we estimate that to be a couple of billion dollars of, market opportunity.
So where is the company at in your clinical development?
So we are currently, in phase two. We've initiated phase two, but our first inpatient enrollment should start somewhere before second quarter of 2019. And so it's a 500-patient study, and we are doing it across all U.S. It's completely a U.S.-based study. And we have the other pipeline that is in preclinical stage, and we have 5 antifungal products, and a couple of them are already commercialized with a large speciality pharma in the globe, by marketing them in India and a few other countries.
So I asked how yours is different than what's currently out there. So how is what you're developing different than some of your peers that might also be developing similar therapeutics?
First and foremost is our molecule is a novel and first-in-class in dermatology acne. Today you have, and whatever is pipeline in antibiotics, is repurposing existing products, that are used in acne where there is already resistance rates. And so coming to our program, it's a first bactericidal, and the KOLs, the clinicians, are very excited about it. And we believe that, it addresses, where current topicals do not work. And our product is a topical gel, and it is not a oral product. So today, current topicals with clindamycin have very, very less, cure rates. And people end up using oral antibiotics and oral isotretinoin, which have very serious side effects. And our product, meets that big unmet need of, offering a new class topical.
And what's your background? I mean, how did you come into all this?
Yeah, my background is that I'm an MBA from one of the premier institutes in India, which has collaboration with Harvard. And I've been part of skincare all through my life. And I was president and CEO for the last 20 years of very large Indian corporations, which had global presence. So one of them is Shanta Biotech, which was a vaccine company. And so that got eventually acquired by Sanofi for $1 billion. And I was also part of a big cosmeceutics company called Imami in India, where I was there as CEO, and I grew the market cap to $2 billion from $200 million.
And Venkat, from what you can tell me, what are some of the company's growth drivers now moving forward?
So our company's growth drivers, you know, the most important milestone that we are looking forward to is completion of phase 2B and having its readouts. You know, we hope to have very good readouts. And the next important milestone is getting into phase 3. And then in antifungal products that we already have, we would like to have, you know, a couple of more deals in next few quarters. And we would like to take one of the pipeline drugs into an IND in next 4 to 5 quarters. So these are the important growth drivers.
And Venkat, where can our audience go and find more information about Vyome Therapeutics?
They can find it on vyometx.com, V-Y-O-M-E-T-X.com.
My name is Robert Kraft, and I'm coming to you live on SNNLive, and we're at the Bio CEO and Investor Conference 2019 in New York. With me again has been Venkat Nelabhotla from Vyome Therapeutics, Inc. It's a private company. Venkat, thank you for joining me today.
Thank you very much, Robert. Thank you.